You are watching Studio 10. They are rude, crude, but very funny. And the Inbetweeners are back with film number 2 about their gap year in Australia. The boys are here in a sec, but first, let's just have a sneak peek at the movie.
She looks well freaked out.
Do you think that might have anything to do with the car?
Doubt it.
This is the classic Aussie shagging wagon.
The mobile virgin conversion unit.
We're backpacking now. Get into the backpacking vibe.
Come to Byron Bay. Oh, it is awesome.
You up for a little...
Darts? I don't think they've got boards.
Katie, can I play you a song?
How about the sound of silence?
If anyone starts playing the bongos, I'm leaving.
Simon, swear on your hoodie you're not going to cheat on me.
I just love you so much.
Basically, I just need to kill myself. And it's got to be easier than breaking up with her.
And we are joined now by 2 of the film stars. Please welcome Blake Harrison and James Buckley, better known as Neil and Jay. Whether I should be washing my hands after shaking your hands.
We were just forced to wash them ourselves, so you're fine.
Because
Jess, you should just get a blood test just to be sure.
Because I have to confess here, I'm an Inbetweeners virgin until I watched your most recent movie.
We've got a cure for that.
And oh my goodness.
Yeah, you got thrown into the deep end. You need to have built up your tolerance over the last 6 years or so.
I couldn't believe it.
Yeah, we go a bit mental in this last film, don't we?
Yeah.
We really
push the envelope.
That advert that you just, that clip you showed
that's
just
the sanitized version.
That's the only part of the film you could ever show during the day.
In the first 2 minutes, I think you violate every possible known law of decency and quite a few actual laws. What made you decide to do the whole thing, you know, in Australia and smashing up some hippies along the way, which I also enjoyed?
Well, it just, you know, it felt like a natural sort of progression. It felt like that's where these characters would be. It's sort of, you know, it's a traditional thing that the British people do is, you know, come over here to sort of spend a year after they finish college before they do university and things like that.
Overstay their visas, get a job.
That's right. That sort of thing, yeah. Try and get far away if possible.
Your character
is
particularly crude, dare I say.
Oh, yeah.
Where does that come from? How do you come up with
England.
That sort of stuff?
It's mainly down to the writers. But I'm not going to lie, I enjoy doing it. And I'm surprised I've been allowed on live television.
Yeah.
It's a risk.
Yeah, it's dangerous. I love it, yeah.
How long have you guys been doing The Inbetweeners as a TV show?
7 years. We started filming the first series in 2007.
And now you guys are kind of pushing 30, getting there.
How long can you
be this immature?
We can be this immature forever. how long we can look that age is, you know, another question. But we can be immature until we're in our 80s, definitely.
Good.
And the film obviously just goes out of its way to offend absolutely everybody, which I applaud. Have you had the usual sort of outrage brigade saying that you've done,
me,
you know,
as the, me.
You know, the hippies,
me.
The hippies
other
tolerance
than you,
union?
No, I mean, I think people know what to expect with The Inbetweeners. And I think the fact of the matter is because they are, you know, in their late teens, I think a lot of the jokes that some people may find offensive, I don't think many would, but I think the ones that people do, it's down to their ignorance and naivety. That's where the comedy comes from. And you can... It's written by 2 men in their 40s, and so there's an air of cynicism about what happens to these characters, and therefore you're laughing at them the whole time. You're rarely laughing with them.
Also, if you are offended as well, you're just, like, a bit of a square. And just...
Oh,
it's not very cool.
Are you calling me a square?
I'm just saying, you know, if you go and see the film and like it, then you're, you know, you're super cool.
These two. But I must say, though, Blake, the part that really made me laugh was that I do like a bit of a poo joke.
Yes.
And
don't we all? Don't we all? It's highbrow humour at its best.
Oh, and so the particular scene where you're on the...
Well, that's great, because that's probably the most disgusting scene that we've ever filmed.
Yeah.
And that you like that... Well...
Is that you? I had beans. I'm sorry.
I am a bit nervous. Sorry.
Remember last year when we said we were going to launch a new sophisticated, highbrow, smart talk morning show? Yeah.
Well, you've got the wrong guests on for that. Yeah.
Were the characters actually based on real people, like guys you know?
They are, yeah. The writers have got friends that I think, you know, for certain reasons, we're not allowed to say exactly who those friends are.
I think we've met them, haven't we?
We have met them, yeah. But, yeah, they are based on real people and amazingly real experiences. Like, some of the horrible things that happened to these characters in the series and the movie actually happened to the writers when they were at a much later age than the characters themselves. So we've got to thank them, really, for having such tragic lives.
And can the two of you now sort of get girls in real life, so to speak, because of the movie, do you think?
Well, all four of us are taken and have been for a long time, yeah. So...
You can hear the hearts breaking across the nation.
Oh, God, that's so gutted.
Sorry, ladies.
So gutted.
Sorry, I'm married.
Now, in between us three, can I look forward to that?
I don't. Unfortunately not. So. You said it yourself. How long are we going to be able to get away with this? No, I think the, you know, what's great about these characters, and you know, it is rude, and they, you know, it can be offensive, but because they're so young and stupid, they don't know what they're saying. They think they're being big and clever, but we all know they're just idiots.
Can't you just be old and stupid and just get mortgages and take a dump in each other's living rooms?
You can, but I don't think that's very funny. I think
it's more tragic.
Yeah, it's more sort of. I don't think you'd like those characters, would you? If they were sort of, if they're supposed to know better and they still behave like that.
The live show is something else altogether.
Well, James and Blake, thanks so much for coming in, and thanks for the laugh. And Inbetweeners 2, it hits cinemas nationwide on the 21st of August, and it really is quite funny.